Greetings. In this video, let's carefully examine John 14:26. What does John 14:26 say? But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. Let's look carefully, phrase by phrase. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost. Well, did you see it? Huh? See what? But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost. Jesus has just told you who the Comforter is. The Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost. It's the Holy Ghost. It's the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit of God. Could it be that easy? Could it really? Yes, it is that easy. You have to try real hard to screw up Jesus' very clear statement. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost. But some people still miss that. So let's keep looking at the rest of John 14:26. Whom the Father will send in my name. What does that mean? Well, it means the Comforter will represent Jesus. God is going to send the Comforter in Jesus' name, in his place, in his authority, as his representative. Some claim that Muhammad did this. But did he? Let's look at that. Did Muhammad represent Jesus? Well, not when Muhammad's command, throughout the Quran, which is the message of Muhammad, was to obey Allah and his prophet Muhammad. There's not once where Muhammad said clearly, "You will obey Allah and his son Jesus." He didn't say that. He said, "Obey Allah and his prophet, Muhammad." So Muhammad primarily represented himself. He did not come in the name of Jesus. He never once said, "I come in the name of Jesus to represent him." He shall teach you all things. This is what the Comforter is supposed to do. The Comforter would teach you all things. You who? Who was Jesus talking to? You, meaning the disciples. Jesus was speaking to his 11 disciples. Those who followed him, those who walked with him, those who were with him. So the Comforter is first and foremost promised to the disciples. This is just such an elementary point of the promise of Jesus that is totally ignored and disrespected by those who call themselves Muslim. So Jesus promised the Comforter. To who? To the disciples. When? During their lives. And when did Muhammad come? 600 years later, after they were dead, of no use to the disciples. Did Muhammad teach the disciples anything? No. Therefore, Muhammad cannot be the Comforter. In fact, has Muhammad taught us all things? Not by any stretch of the imagination. And bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I, Jesus, have said unto you, the disciples. Did Muhammad remind us of anything Jesus taught? did Muhammad remind us of the Sermon on the Mount? Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are the poor in spirit, blessed are the poor in heart. Did Muhammad remind us of any part of the Sermon on the Mount? Did he say, hey, remember the Sermon on the Mount that Jesus taught? No. No, he did not. How about did Muhammad remind us when Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come to the Father but by me. Or when Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Did Muhammad remind us of this? Or did Muhammad remind us when Jesus said, I am the Son of God? Did Muhammad remind us of that? Or did Muhammad have something different to say? Because, you know, the Comforter was promised to put us in remembrance of all that Jesus said. It doesn't say the Comforter will come and contradict what Jesus said. No, Muhammad did not remind us of any of those declarations and teachings by Jesus. Muhammad simply does not fit the description which Jesus gave. This means Muhammad cannot possibly be the Comforter. It is simply impossible. So who could the Comforter be? How about the Holy Ghost? How about the Holy Spirit of God that Jesus first and foremost said, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost? Think about it. Jesus is very clear. He said it. He was clear. He was not confused. He was not ambiguous. He was speaking to the disciples, and he promised them the Holy Ghost. If you are a Christian, do not be deceived by the weak and provably false claims that Muhammad is the Comforter. It doesn't matter how often they repeat it. It doesn't matter how loudly they proclaim it. It's simply false. You have to read the whole description of the Comforter. And John 14:26 absolutely proves that it can't be Muhammad. And if you call yourself Muslim, meaning you declare that you submit to God, do not claim the word Comforter from the description of Jesus and then reject the entire description of the Comforter, the one that Jesus would send. If you're going to dare claim the Comforter, read the description. Otherwise, you fool yourselves. If Jesus' promise of a Comforter was true, so was his description. Honor his words if you honor him as a prophet. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.